Observer 2000 here, back again doing another video here. I'm here at Norfolk County River Park here in Athens, and I'm currently walking to the Trail Creek Railroad Trestle here, other known by locals here as the Murmur Trestle. I say that because that's an album that R.E.M. made, and for the back cover picture they used a photo of this trestle, and it was in use by CSX I think until the early 80s, and they ended up tearing it down. In fact, there's the picture right there, and here's what the trestle looks like currently. And well, here it is at present in 2020. You can see the bottom parts of it. Just trying to walk fairly far from the road. It's like got that much distance from me. Now if you look right there, there's where the railroad embankment was, because that's where the Firefly Trail now sits. That's the this end, approach end of the bridge, and then, well, here's where they demolished it partially. There would have been a steel span crossing the road, but here's the bridge as it looks currently, and I'll be getting pictures afterwards, but I just wanted to show y'all. Now currently, from what I've read recently, the city is currently trying to decide what to do with the structure. They're not sure if they should tear the whole thing down and rebuild it, or if they should, like, say, tear down, say, this side and then the other end of the approach and build steel approaches, or if they should keep the bridge and then demolish parts of it and have a path curving all through it. They're not sure what they want to do. But we'll just have to see what happens, because I guess that currently the city cannot make up its mind on what they want to do with it. But for now, it still stands as is. Just like it's been for the past 30 years. Now there is a steel deck piece there in the middle where the bridge goes over the creek, and I'll try and show it if I can. It's just a matter of trying to get to it. There's a little biking trail there. Currently, I'm currently walking down this one, but you can see this would probably be better shown in the winter time when there isn't much cover by the trees. But you can see that this little trail comes out here and merges with the main one. And you'll see the steel part of the bridge here. Let's see if I can't do this without looking at it. Yeah, there's the part of the bridge that has the steel deck up there. So that's paint clinging to it. And then you've got the creek here. As you can see there. So I'm going to just speed this up now because my battery is nearly dead. So. Here's a better view of the creek. Sorry, I'm on borrowed time. My battery's dying, so I'm trying to not, you know, lose it. But you can see through the trees the rest of there, the rest of the bridge. In fact, I'll try and get up here as quickly as I can to show you guys what this thing looks like through the timber truss portions, which are these, all of these pillars. As you look up, you can see that there is a good bit of deterioration to the bridge. In fact, right there is how much wood would have been there for, you know, supporting the track above. And there's how much is left in some places. Or you can see there's just like a web of wood, which is kind of, for me, interesting to see, because you don't see bridges, like, it's rare for you to see wooden bridges built and subsequently used by railroads anymore in the modern day. They usually just replace them with steel or concrete structures now. Only on rail trails do you actually see newer wooden bridges, like, say, the Abingdon Branch, for example. They lost quite a few of the original bridges, and so they had to rebuild them. You can see most of the X-trussing, the wooden X-trussing, is lost here on this portion of the bridge. This was probably a road at one point, and you could drive underneath the trestle. But, yeah, you can see that this is what it looks like as far as how it currently stands. So, I'm going to end the video here and see if I can get whatever pictures I can get before my camera dies, and I'll see y'all later. Railroad Preserver 2000 here, back again doing another video here, and this is the Trail Creek Trestle that I'm filming it for what may be the last time. I just spoke with one of the construction guys, and from what I hear, they're going to start, demolition of the entire span, what's left of it. So I'm out here trying my best to get as many photographs of it as I can before they completely tear it down. I thought they were going to go with the plan to demo the approaches and build a steel span, but I guess they went with just a whole new bridge. It's probably going to be a concrete one, so I'm going to see if I can get some more pictures on the other side where it's clear while I still have a chance before it's completely torn down. So I'll give you an update when I can, I suppose. I'm here in Athens again, and I'm currently walking on what was, until like the 1990s, the portion of railroad that was owned and used. Before that, I think one of its predecessor roads used it, but it was in use until a chemical plant further up here ended up closing, and after that they just tore up all the trackage. So I think this was the old, one of the seaboard railroads, older railroad grades into Athens. The one over on Pulaski Street that you've seen me frequent, the Abbeville sub, it's still in use. This one was more or less a industrial spur by the time it was finally abandoned. All the trackage from Warnerville to Union Point was already gone by the early 80s. From what I could tell by pictures, the tracks still ran through Crawford until 1982, but were probably pulled shortly after that. Here's the first bridge crossing the Oconee River. The original structure, supposedly when they demolished it, fell into the river, and it's still mostly down there today. The parts that they just simply couldn't get out. We're now on what would have been one of, I think, three bridges that this rail line went over at one time. This is the only one that I guess you could say has been quote-unquote rebuilt. I've already got pictures and video of me walking across it before, but I've got my camera because I want to get pictures of the Trail Creek Trestle before they begin the partial demo or complete demolition of it. Funny thing is, if they had of started this thing about 20 years ago, they could have included the original bridge as it is, but they waited too late. Now they're gonna have to demolish them a good 90% of the original structure just so they can incorporate what's left, or what may not be enough of the original bridge. Hold on, I've got to get this thing over, it's freezing. Got an overlook here. So yeah, here's the Oconee River. And here's how you can tell this was a railroad bridge. You can see down there, you can see the old abutments for the original railroad bridge that was here, then the concrete abutments from when they built the new railroad bridge, and then the more recent concrete pieces for when they built this bridge to replace it. See, there's another stone pillar there. Nice dog.
Thank you.
Here's the view from the other side. Trestle is right down there. About 10 to 15 years ago, you could actually climb up the side of the embankment, basically up the side of the grade, and you could actually more or less get pictures, unobstructed pictures of the trestle. Now, believe it or not, I think I'm seeing railroad ties down there. Yeah, down there, I think, are some old railroad ties. Whether or not they're from the railroad grade, I don't know, but I wouldn't be surprised if they were. Some of them. Yep, they are. That's what that is. The railroad ties. I see a tie plate sticking out of one of them right down there, right down in the gully. That's amazing. I did not expect to see that. Look here. Right there. Part of an old railroad tie with steel tie plate for the track still in one piece. That's surprising. I didn't know that was down there. Yeah, continuing the walk towards the second bridge, the only original bridge that still has some parts of it left. I'm sure at one point there was probably milepost markers and signals alongside the right-of-way, but thing is, if they ever had a use for this as a railroad route again, they could easily tear this out and relay the tracks. I mean, yes, it would cost a good bit still to put it down, new ballast, new ties, new rail, but the thing is this trail's already got the right-of-way cleared. So, it would cost a lot still, but it wouldn't cost nearly as much in regards to clearing out plants and other debris. But they're wanting this trail to go from Athens all the way to Union Point and return. So mostly the entire right-of-way. And the trestle is just ahead here. So if a train were coming from Athens in the direction I'm heading, it would be going towards Winterville, and this would be the engineer's side. Conductor would be on this side, probably filling out paperwork. And then, of course, if a train was coming from Winterville going to Athens, if a train was coming from Winterville, the engineer would be facing this way, and the conductor would be on the side I'm walking on, if that makes sense. I've actually been meaning to look alongside the grade, because right there, there's more old railroad ties in the gully. I just noticed them right there. There's one there rotted out. There's probably stuff from the old bridge that the railroad company dumped off to the side of the embankment later on. But yeah, here's the Trail Creek Trestle. And this will be the first time I've ever actually gotten to see it from the top. Because before, when I tried this, the shrubbery was still growing up all around the bridge, but it's still intact for now. But they're going to start demolishing what's left any time now. So here it is. Here is the old Trail Creek trestle, made famous by R.A.M.'s album Murmur, because this trestle was photographed for the back cover. And this is what it looks like now, 40-something years after they took the picture. Because it was, that photo of it was taken in 1983, and here's the same bridge 40 years later, long after its rail use has ended. And about 10 or 15 years after the band itself has stopped touring, they stopped, I think they ended what they were doing in 2011. I would have been 10 to 11 years old. But what I heard is they're going to try and demolish where the bridge approached the grade here, and where part of where it would have crossed the road has already been torn down, but they're probably going to tear out a few more feet of that. What they're wanting to do is they're wanting to demolish most of the wooden structure and put a steel arch span in its place. And I think from what I've seen in concepts, they're wanting to keep the center span that has that steel piece right there. They're wanting to try and keep that intact so at least a tiny fragment of the original bridge still exists. I mean, if it were me, what I would do is I'd get a crane out here and I'd try and lift the steel span off and put it on display in the park down there, and maybe have a replica of railroad track put on top of it to show just how they would have laid it on top of this bridge. Because you wouldn't think the railroad tracks would fit on this, but they would, because they had ties that were wide enough. But you can see the grade here. And I tell you, I would not be all that surprised if there was some spikes left behind, like some that had ended up falling down the side of the embankment somewhere. If you had a metal detector or a magnet, you could probably get some. But yeah, this here is it. This here's the bridge. This is the first time I've ever actually been able to see the top of it in person. A guy who did a website covering a lot of the old railroad lines in Athens, ones that have long since been ripped up and some that are still here, had photos that he took of this bridge before it looked anything like this. It was still abandoned, but it was still in a fairly decent shape, because by then it had only been owned by the city for about 8, maybe 10 years. But had they have started this trail then, I bet you they could have used the original bridge and they would have only had to rebuild the part that went over the road over there, across the gap. But that's then and then now, I suppose. So this is probably, I'm probably going to be one of the last people to get pictures of this thing as it is. And if any of you guys are near Athens or in the area, I recommend doing the same thing I'm doing right now, because this bridge may be here right now today, but it could be gone within the next week or two at the late, at like, and that's just the soonest date. You know, they may have it gone in a few days. I personally give it less. I'd probably give it a few hours, depending on when they're going to start tearing it down. So I say it to you again, if any of y'all are in the Athens area or nearby, I'd try and stop by here and get as many damn photos of this thing as you can while the light's still good and while the bridge is still here, because it could be gone within the next few days or a few weeks, who knows. But I've got my camera with me, so I'm going to do what I came here for. I'm going to get some pictures of this sucker. No real way to get the bridge from the side, but maybe there is. Look right here. I'm tempted to walk in the woods a little bit, because like I said earlier, I
I saw, well, as y'all saw, I found a tie plate that may have still had something from the other bridge still on it. So I want to see if I could find something, because the railroad had to, there's no way the railroad could have taken everything out. But there's a good, here's a good side view of the bridge. If they cut all this down temporarily, then you'd get a good view of it. But here it is from the side. That is the Trail Creek Trestle. Across the way there, across the road in the gap from where it was torn down, is where the roadbed continues across another bridge to Winterville. The chemical plant is just a few miles away, about a few minutes away by car. Less so by train if it were still in use. But I'm going to get more photos. I'm filming it because, for all I know, I'm the only other person actually getting anything of recent of this bridge. I haven't seen any photos of it from the until today. Somebody by the name of Joshua Long, I think, came over here and got pictures. But I'm trying to get video documentation of it before what's here is gone for good. Because once they tear this down, I mean, that's it. My battery is starting to die too, so I have to, I hate to say it, but my battery's going. So I'm going to have to cut the stream short, so this is probably going to be the last time I ever see the Trail Creek Trestle in its original form, so to speak. I'll see y'all later.